play some of the classic favorite polka music the way we may remember them, but in a little different way.
They studied the navigation, the engineering, the physical problems of space flight.
He was told there was no room for his accordion or for polka music in the official high school band.
Finally, the long program of training, development, and testing was complete.
Certainly are the new face of polka music.
Go for deploy.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's time now for the Chardon Polka Band's Interweb Polka Extravaganza and Podcast. Starring your host, Jake Cowie. Featuring Mike Franklin. Mitch Lawrence. And Bob Young. And now, from the Chardon Polka Band's world headquarters in Bergen, Ohio, here's your host, Jake Cowie.
All right, friends and neighbors, how we doing this week? It's Jake broadcasting here live from Chardon Polka Band World Headquarters in Burton, Ohio. Good to see so many of y'all. Already seeing y'all over on the scroller here on Facebook. And, of course, some of you guys are tuning in via podcast, and we appreciate y'all listening. We hope we don't melt your ears, ladies and gentlemen. That's all I can say about the program tonight. We hope we don't melt your ears. The format of our program changes week to week. Last week, it was just me and my dad here in the basement playing live music for you. And, of course, this week, here I am again with just the deer and the dinosaur back here chilling out. Mr. Jake Cowie here from the Chardon Polka Band. And speaking of the Chardon Polka Band, let's jump into some Chardon Polka Band tunes. I'm just going to lay it on you. This one's called the Pennsylvania Polka. I'll explain where this recording came from in just a minute after the tune has played. But I want to get right into the music tonight. Here we go.
The Pennsylvania Polka. Maybe we got some Pennsylvanians out there. We certainly hope not. No, they're all right. The Pennsylvania Polka for all our Pennsylvanians.
So carefree.
friends and neighbors, that's the Pennsylvania Polka.
Yes, indeed it is. One of our very favorite polkas, the Pennsylvania Polka, boys and girls. And we hope that you guys like that one, whether you're from Pennsylvania or not. It's still a great song, a great polka. Now, some of you guys were asking about the location of that video where we saw the whole Chardon Polka Band together playing and having a good time. That video was shot here in the Notre Dame Village. It's a senior living, independent living area around the corner from us, and kind of attached to the Notre Dame compound there. Oh my goodness, a lot of fun. And of course, some of these senior living places that we'd normally perform at during a typical year, we haven't gotten to go into recently at all. So we were glad they came up with a plan to do it safely. We were set up out in their parking lot, and residents were at least 100 feet away from us, I would say. And they were in the various parking spaces around this big circle that the band was playing in. It was kind of fun because we played in the round, you know, we all kind of had our backs to each other. And then Bob Young on the drums behind everybody. But Mitch was facing over to the right. I was facing straight ahead to a group there. Mike was facing a group over here because they had residents all around us. So we wanted to make sure each of them kind of had a person to focus on. And what fun is that? Hopefully you enjoyed that fun tune and that fun video. I'm going to actually hoping to post in the next few days an entire set from there. Of course, our hymn from tomorrow, Standing on the Promises of God. We got a new hymn that will be on YouTube for you guys tomorrow. It comes from that session, and I'm gonna post a whole set of music from that because it's always great to get together with the full band. And of course, this pandemic is making it tough to do so. So we're happy to get out and play. And again, happy that some of these facilities are finding ways to entertain their residents and do it safely. So if you know of such a facility that would be in need of some socially distanced music, let them know. The Chardon Polka Band will come out. We'll play anywhere. We'll do it. You know, if we can do it safely, we will do it. So moving right along, speaking of the whole band, we got together in the digital fashion for a Zoom meeting, and I would like to play you the results of that. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Jake Cowie from the Chardon Polka Band. So for this week, I just want to throw in some fun questions. These are some questions from one of our valued fans, Ryan Praisledorf. Would you want to fly for a day or be invisible for a day?
I would have to choose the flying.
Yeah.
Based on my knowledge of Dragon Ball Z. And they can fly so fast that they become invisible. So,
what if it's a trick question? I mean, you could just be on an airplane for a day, or you could be invisible, and he got you. He got you all.
Flying Delta for a day, or
Spirit Airlines. Like, you're stuck on Spirit Airlines. All right. Best type of cheese? Question mark.
It's easy. It's got to be pepper jack cheese.
Gouda.
Gouda?
Oh, man. Bob, yeah. You and I have similar cheese taste, bro. Gouda.
Why?
All right. It's tasty.
Good cheese.
I feel like sharp cheddar can be used on everything.
That's pretty good, but we made a chicken parmesan and we put pepper jack cheese on it. It turned out okay because it was a white jack cheese. So it was like, yeah, similar to the provolone that we didn't have.
No, I actually don't like provolone.
Really?
Yeah.
Why not? Defend yourself.
We'd always get pizza from a place when I was a kid, and they always have it cooked light, and they always use provolone as their cheese. And I just, for some reason, that whole texture, just like, I hated it. I hated cheese on pizza for a long time, but I've come back around to, I would just peel it off. But now I'm just a normal person. So
I feel like this has already been covered. They asked, what would the world be like if we had female copies of ourselves? That's the Spice Girl. We covered that.
Spice Girl.
We covered that a couple weeks ago.
Jake, by the way, I was thinking of a great cover song we could do during the medley. We could go, tell you what you want, what you really, really want. I want a really ziggy zaggy ziggy zaggy. Hi, hi, hi.
Word. Would you rather explore space or the ocean?
I used to think space was cool, and then I was like, well, that's something that I already get to see at night because we live in the country.
Yeah.
So you can just look up, and that's space.
Yeah, you've seen it all.
Look up is space. I find the depths of the ocean is like kind of calling me.
I for me, it would depend on whether this is like sci-fi technology or current day technology.
Yeah.
Because right at the moment, we can't get very far in space.
Yeah.
So that's boring. So right. I'd rather do the ocean. But if we're talking like I can, you know, travel like Star Trek.
Or yeah. or Stargate.
Oh, or even better.
That's even faster. Would you want to be twice as strong as you are with fingers in your ears or crawl twice as fast as you run? So would
what?
You want
I would have to go with the crawl.
Would you want
so
to be
you're twice as strong?
You'd be you could be twice as strong as you are, but you'd have fingers in your ears. Or maybe coming out of your ears. Or oh. You could crawl twice as fast as you can run.
Some strength. I was thinking it would be a guy like going like this.
Yeah.
And I thought, well, if my legs got to be really strong, it's like you can't use your arms.
It's a bad question.
Well, but I think they're just two very unfortunate superpowers. Like,
I'm going to take the crawling. It's less inconvenient, I think, while you have the skill.
Your knees would be killing you. I guess you could get some real nice knee pads.
Get some nice knee pads, you know?
You wear sneakers on your knees.
They call them sneakers, but they spell it with a K.
You could theoretically crab walk. Is that still crawling?
That's you'd be sprinting around stage crab walk style.
All right, segue this into last series. It's a build-on question. We were talking about this at a show the other week. The number one question our band gets asked, like we'll be unloading at a show at a gazebo and someone will inevitably come up and go, who's playing here tonight? Despite the fact we're wearing stuff like this. And we'll say the Chardon Polka Band. And then they inevitably say,
what kind of music do you play?
Exactly. Yeah. And then we tell them, oh, polka music. And then they follow that up with,
well, where are you from?
Every stinking time. This is like
we gotta hold up a sign.
Mitch is holding a sign that says don't look at this chicken. I just lost the chicken game. Thanks, Mitch. I wanted to reflect on that as we're reflecting on some of these silly questions a fan submitted. That's probably the silliest one of the serious series of questions because they keep going, you know.
I'll get off stage in between sets. And they'll ask me if I'm with those guys. Are you with these guys? No.
Really, really want. I want a ziggy doggy, ziggy doggy. Hi, hi, hi.
Oh my goodness. Ladies and gentlemen, it don't get any more fun than that. There it is. There's my gang, the Chardon Polka Band. Mr. Mike Franklin, master of the strings. Mr. Bob Young, master of nothing. And Mr. Mitch Lawrence, woodwind player extraordinaire. And that okay, so these questions were submitted to us by a fan, Ryan Preisledorf. You guys are welcome to submit questions as well. You can write them to us on Facebook. Don't do it in the comment section if you want us to answer them on one of these Zoom meetings. Send us a Facebook message or send us an email, chardonpolkaband@gmail.com. Those of you listening on the podcast, what's wrong with you? Why are you listening to this podcast? Find a new hobby. All right. So we go with that last question is a real question. People ask us at shows. They come up and, you know, we're wearing all this polka paraphernalia. My hat says polka on it. And they say, hey, you know, somebody playing music here tonight. Yeah, yeah. What kind of music do you play? And we go, what's your name? We're the Chardon Polka Band. What do you play? Polka music. Yeah, you know, it's good stuff. Hold on. We'll spin the camera around. I'll just do this. the old school way. There's Emily coming in with, who we got, Benjamin?
Yeah.
We got Benjamin in the house tonight. Emily and Benjamin walking down, bringing Dad some dinner. What do I got here? A freezer meal?
Chicken Alfredo, yeah.
Honey, you shouldn't have. Chicken Alfredo. If you're listening at home, my wife is, if you're listening on the podcast, once again, why would you? But my wife is here, Emily and one of my sons. I have two of them. This is Benjamin, and they have brought me chicken Alfredo from the freezer, but it's good. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I'm Jake Cowie from the Chardon Polka Band, and we're going to continue with some music. Love you guys.
Love you.
All right. There we go. Spinning the camera back around. Oh my goodness, there. Hold on, let me take these headphones off so I can play the accordion properly. All right, now, this song came to me after I was, doing these questions with the guys. I went, I need to play this one. This is not a song I wrote. This is one by a folk singer called Todd Schneider. I got too much to think about, too much to figure out. Stuck between hope and a doubt, it's too much to think about, too much to think about. They say 3% of people use 5 to 6% of their brain. 97% use just 3% and the rest goes down the drain. I never know which one I am, but I bet you my last dime. 99% think with 3% 100% of the time. I got too much to think about, too much to figure out. Stuck between hope and a doubt, it's a too much to think about. I said it's too much to think about. Now 64% of all the world's statistics are made up right there on the spot. 82.4% of people believe them, whether they're accurate statistics or not. Well, I don't know what you believe, but I do know there's no doubt I need another double shot of something 90 proof. I got too much to think about, too much to think about, too much to figure out. Stuck between hope and doubt, it's too much to think about, it's too much to think about. Now, 84% of all statisticians, they don't like their jobs. They'd rather have themselves a beer and eat chicken kebabs. Rather than sing about statistics all day long, just spend your time on a polka song. Dig what you do and you can't go wrong. I got too much to think about. I said, too much to think about, too much to figure out. Stuck between hope and a doubt, it's a too much to think about. It's too much to think about. It's too much to think about. All right, now I did not write that one. I did have to throw a few new lyrics in there. Todd Schneider cusses a little bit now and then in his music, just about every song, I guess. And we got, this is a kids program. There's kids watching. We can't have foul language. Oh my goodness. But check out Todd Schneider, not with the kids, you know. Check out Todd Schneider, wonderful folk, a musician. Yeah, Thomas Hooks, he's a mathematician. He is joined listening to the program, watching the program. He enjoyed that one, little statistics blues polka for you. I wanna call you sweetheart, I wanna call you dear, but words just fail me whenever you are near. I wanna take you dancing, I wanna hold you tight, I wanna know that feeling of delight. I wish I had the courage, like the other guys, to look at you with love light in their eyes. Excuse me, did you say you'd like to dance with me? Oh honey, yes. Wanna call you sweetheart, wanna call you dear,
but words just fail me whenever you are near. Wanna take you dancing, I wanna hold you tight. I wanna know that feeling of delight. Wish I had the courage like the other guys who look at you with love light in their eyes. Excuse me, did you say you like to dance with me? Oh, honey, yes, sirree.
All right, folks, we got a request, and we've done this song on the show every 4 or 5 episodes, and we're up to, this is number 17. Oh, my goodness. And some of these songs, it's just unavoidable to play them multiple times because I love them dearly, and they get requested all the time. Now, this one goes out to our friend Roberta, and Roberta says, my dad always loved In Heaven There Is No Beer. His name was Stan. He passed away 8/16 of 2010. So we're going to play this one in memory of Stan. In heaven there is no beer, that's why we drink it here. When we are gone from here, our friends will be drinking all our beer. La 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 la. In heaven, there's no beer, that's why we drink it here. And when we're gone from here, our friends will be drinking all our beer. La 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 la. All right, here we go. La 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 la. La 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 la. Hey, in heaven there is no beer. On the Cordovox here. Oh my goodness. Gotta start wiggling the wires on the Cordovox. Got some extra reverb coming off the tubes there. For those of you guys who do not know what this instrument is, the Cordovox is half accordion, half organ. It was, I think, originally in the 1950s is when these came about. There's not that many of them left, but they are pretty darn awesome. I love this thing. So, ladies and gentlemen, moving right along, going to play some more music from the gang here. This one, we're going to switch things up. This one's not a polka. It's an old doo-wop song called Do-Do-Run-Run.
For those of you guys who don't know our backstory, the Chardon Polka Band started out in the year 2003 as a high school project back in 2003. And then it kind of became a hobby for a few years before we decided to take it on the road, make it into a career, ladies and gentlemen, a very strange but fun career. So we are happy to be here playing our polkas for you guys today, spreading our polkas near and far, and seeing some happy faces along the way today.
Still, to D-run, to D-run. Well, somebody told me her name was Jill. To D-run, to D-run. I said, yeah, my heart stood still. Yeah, her name was Jill. Yeah, and when I walked her home, to D-run, to D-run. Run. Well, I fed her up at 7, she looked so fine. Do-run, and I'll sign her real soon, I will make her mine. Do-run, I say, yeah, she looks so fine. Yeah, I'm gonna make her mine. Yeah, and when I walk her home, do-run. Said, D-run,
that's good stuff, ladies and gentlemen. Good stuff you're watching and listening to. And good stuff I'm eating, this frozen dinner of chicken Alfredo. My wife made it with love. Of course, you saw her, Emily and Benjamin, bring this wonderful dish down to me. And speaking of dishes, I'm going to dish out another song to you from the Chardon Polka Band, both because that was an awesome segue perpetrated by Jake Cowie, and because I'd like to finish this delicious meal. So here you go. Here's another one of my favorite tunes that we do. It's called the Sloop John B.
All right, we're going to do one for you called the Sloop John B. This is an old summertime favorite. Beach Boys played it, as did the Kingston Trio.
Come on to Sloop John B. John B. sails. See how the mainsail sets. Call for the captain ashore and let me go. I wanna go home. Let me go home. I feel so broke up. He had to come and take him away. Sheriff Johnstone, leave me alone. I feel so broke up. I wanna go. Hoist up the John B. sails. See how the mainsail sets. Then he took and he ate up all of our corn. So I said, let me go home. I want to go home. This is the worst trip that I have been on. What's up, the John B. sails? See how the mainsail sets. Woohoo! Call for the captain ashore and let me go. I wanna go. Let me go. Well, if peace is broken, I wanna go.
All right, let's break this one down.
John B. sails. See how the mainsail sets.
Oh yeah!
Call for the captain ashore and let me go home.
Hey, hey!
I wanna go home. Why don't you let me go home?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh yeah! Well, if peace is broke up, I wanna go. Wanna go home.
along back there on the drums having fun. We're all having fun here this morning at Notre Dame. Thanks for hanging out with us, making some merry music this morning for you guys.
Oh my goodness. So you know that everything is on point and the band is having a good time and we are in the pocket, ladies and gentlemen, when you see the Jake's hands go up like this during a song, you know. We went into that breakdown and I expanded my hands and what's that doing? I'm embracing the polka, boys and girls. I'm attempting to give it a hug, bring more of it into my nostrils, into my oral cavity, into my chest, and just bring the polka and breathe it in and feel it so that I can breathe it back out. So I had my hands held up during that song. I go, "What's up, the John B. Sales?" I wasn't even playing my accordion at that point in the song. I was just enjoying it. You'll see me even sometimes when I'm playing the accordion, I'll keep the left hand going. I'll raise my hand in the air and I'll just feel that polka music radiating through my body. Friends and neighbors. Oh, friends and neighbors, can you feel the polka music radiating through your body? It feels real good. All my friends and neighbors watching my live stream or listening to my podcast, I hope it feels good. But maybe that's just my chicken Alfredo talking. Or maybe that's just my chicken Alfredo running its course on me. I don't know, but we'll see. Well, my friends and neighbors, can you feel that polka music from your head down to your toes? That polka music, it goes into your ears, and if you're not careful, it'll come out your nose. You gotta watch polka music. It might come out your nose, ladies and gentlemen, because polka is unpredictable. Oh, polka is the music that we love. I hadn't planned on playing this song, mainly because I'm making it up. I never heard this song before. That means you've never heard it before. I had my guitar out for another reason. I was gonna sing a kid's song. But then that polka music hit me. And I said, I gotta sing a jam about it. Well, there's no feeling in the earth like polka music. It's like lava burning up my brain. Polka music's like a jet flying through the sky. It's also like an old railroad train going chugga 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 chugga. And that's the polka train. Oh, and that's the polka train, my dear. Oh, friends and neighbors, I'm the Jake, and I don't know if that was entertaining. I'll watch the playback later and see. You know, sometimes this stuff just hits you. It hits you in your soul. Music is like that. And I only get that feeling because I was listening to the gang sing Sloop John B. You know, that's not a feeling I usually get when I'm by myself. I got to be with the band feeling that music. I love it. Do you love it? I hope you love the program tonight. I used to play music with this guy Don Landes, great guy. He would feel the music and he would screech. He'd belt out these tunes way up here. Ah! You know, I can't sing that high, as you just heard, but you know, that's how he felt the music. And I just thought I'd share that with you. Yeah, it's been an interesting program tonight. I hope you enjoyed it. I ate a lot of chicken Alfredo and applesauce, and we got to watch the band play, ladies and gentlemen, over at Notre Dame villages. And like I mentioned earlier, if you know of a facility that has, especially if they have an outdoor location like that where the folks can separate from us, we can separate from them, and they can also distance from each other, we would love to go play there. You know, we'd love to. It was so great to see these faces lit up. We play there regularly, you know, in a typical year, and they just miss the music, you could tell, and we miss playing for them. All right, we're gonna roll over to the kids' corner. It's about that time, right, friends and neighbors, before I ramble too long. Oh, yeah, we are the kids' corner now. Boom. All right, this is for all our kids out there. You know, we were talking about when we did that band interview on Zoom earlier in the show. If we could explore outer space or the sea, which one would we rather do? And maybe some of you kids out there have thought about exploring. Maybe you explore your own backyard. Maybe you're out having a bonfire and you look up at those stars and you go, man, wouldn't I just love to run away to those stars? And yeah, that is, it's fun to get out there and see what there is. But ladies and gentlemen, there ain't no place like home, and I want to sing to you about it. I'd like to visit the moon on a rocket ship high in the air. Well, I'd like to visit the moon, but I don't think I'd like to live there. Though I like to look down at the earth from above, I miss all the places and people I love. So although I might like it for one afternoon, I don't want to live on the moon. I'd like to travel under the sea. I'd visit the fish everywhere. Oh, I'd travel under the sea, but I don't think I'd like to live there. Well, I'd stay for a day now if I had my wish, but there's not much to do if your friends are all fish, and an oyster and clam aren't a real family. So I don't want to live in the sea. I'd like to visit the jungle, hear the lion roar, go back in time and meet a dinosaur. So many strange places I'd like to see, but none of them permanently. Ain't that the truth, friends and neighbors? So if I could visit the moon, I'd dance on a moonbeam, and then I'd make a wish on a star, and I'd wish I was home once again. Though I like to look down at the earth from above, I miss all the places and the people I love. Although I might go there, I'll be coming home soon, 'cause I don't wanna live on the moon. No, I don't wanna live on the moon. My goodness. Ryan McMerryfly joining us again this week. He says over there into the kids' corner, he speaks his voice and he says that's one of his favorite songs from his childhood. I believe Ernie used to sing that one on Sesame Street. One time he even had Aaron Neville with him. You kids don't know who Aaron Neville is. If you're in the kids' corner and you're a kid, you have no idea who Aaron Neville is unless you have happened to catch that repeat of Sesame Street. But for all you, you know, grown-up people, Aaron Neville was a guy who went, I don't know much, but I know how I love you. That may be all I need to know. Yeah, that's right. I got halfway through that, kids. I was like, I don't know much, but I know I love you. And I was like, I could end it there, but I could keep going.
that may be all I need to know. Oh, man. We're having a rad time tonight, ladies and gentlemen, and I hope you're having a rad time. My dad instructed me. He's watching the program there at home. And when I started out tonight, the Accordion Babes calendar was not present. Oh, my goodness. And it's what was that? It's back up there now. August and Wendy Fitz pretty soon. Is it the end of August yet? I have no idea, ladies and gentlemen. I think this weekend would have been the German Fest and German Fest picnic in Dayton, Ohio, where we usually see so many of you folks. And then we actually, this next week, we weren't playing at German Fest this week, though we did do some virtual stuff for them for the virtual festival. We weren't going to be playing there this year. We were going to miss a year because next week we would have been headed out to Utah. And we would have already played about 100 shows this summer, so we were like, we need a weekend off. Well, we didn't need a weekend off this year. Anyway. So we'd be heading to Utah probably this Wednesday or Thursday, but we're not doing that because everything is canceled. You know. Anyway, friends and neighbors, thanks for joining me tonight. I'm Jake Cowie from the Chardon Polka Band. And while I am in my basement broadcasting to you, I couldn't do a Chardon Polka Band without a band, my great friends, Mr. Mike Franklin, Mr. Bob Young, Mr. Mitch Lawrence, and they appreciate you guys watching as well. And if you guys like the program tonight, if you like listening to it in your ear sockets on the podcasted version, you can support us, leave us a tip at Venmo, venmo.com/Chardon Polka Band. You can also send a good old-fashioned check, to P.O. Box 908. Well, if you're an old-fashioned guy like me, and you don't like to watch the TV, you just like to write checks. That's my impromptu song about checks, ladies and gentlemen. You can send a check to P.O. Box 908, Burton, Ohio, 44021. And Patreon. Patreon is a wonderful way to support us. There's a monthly contribution to the Chardon Polka Band. And we're really trying to build our platform or our Patreon patrons up. Oh my goodness. We're trying to get more of them because that's kind of how we're doing work this year. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, friends and neighbors, one of the best ways to support us, go over to the website, www.chardonpolkaband.com, and buy some tasty merchandise. I'm rocking my Chardon Polka Band skull hat this evening because we were out of these and I've got like 8 boxes stacked over there for people who ordered them, and then I was like, oh no, we run out, so I ordered more, and then they got like stuck in Utah, as a matter of fact. I know I was just talking about Utah. Our hat lady is in Utah, and now they're here, so if you ordered a hat, I will be sending those out. Yes, Mike, I know you bring us the platform beer. And no further contribution needed from Mike or anybody. You know, I'm just happy you guys are watching the program, viewing the program, listening to the program. You do not have to give us money. I'll still show up and do this in my basement. In fact, I do this in my basement every single night of the week. I only turn the streaming device on for one of those nights, and it's Saturday. But every other night, I'm down here putting on a show. For nobody. It's very interesting at the Cowie House, Polka World Headquarters, as it were. Ladies and gentlemen, I was talking about the band, though, and let me play another song from our wonderful, wonderful, wonderful time over there at Notre Dame. Here's one called the Tick Tock Polka. Thank you.
the clap, keeping time while the music is played. Oh, tick, 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 tock is a rhythm it makes, and I know it won't make you feel blue. Oh, tick, 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 tockles my heart with the clock, 'cause it knows that I'm dancing with you.
Somebody mentioned I haven't been promoting Platform Beer this episode, so now I'm holding up a Platform Beer sign, so you know what kind of beer we enjoy. I don't actually have one down here with me this evening for the program. I hope that the program has been okay. I just hope it's been all right. I still am thinking about Platform Beer. You know, Platform Beer isn't just a beverage, it's a state of mind, and I am there. I was actually having some technical difficulties before the program, so I was kind of hustling to set everything up. I was supposed to be making dinner tonight, and I did not. Emily was bringing me down because I was running late on everything. I just ran up, grabbed my polka clothes, and was like, I gotta go, the show's about to start. Yeah, that's my impression of me, by the way. I run around my house like a lunatic going, yeah, I gotta get my polka clothes, the show's about to start. Oh my goodness, folks love those videos, and I'm happy you like the videos. We've gotten several comments over popping up in the comment bar. One of them mentioned the wonderful, wonderful clarinet on that last tune. That was the TikTok polka. But when Mitch has his clarinet out, every song is the clarinet polka. He shreds that thing, blows everybody away. Oh my goodness. And I was on the accordion too, ladies and gentlemen. Of course, Mike Franklin on the banjo and Bob Young on the drums. Good stuff. He's Mitch, heck of a clarinet player. It's wonderful. And then several people have also mentioned, now this doesn't as much tickle your fancy if you're listening to the podcast, but on those videos we've been showing, there's a lot of drone shots, those shots from up in the sky circling the band. You can see the band, you can see the whole place. Now that stuff's coming. Mike Franklin bought a drone recently, a few months back. We were really excited to use it for all our shows this summer. We didn't know there were only going to be four of them at the time. No, but seriously, Mike Franklin is a wonderful gentleman, and he's one of these guys, he's always trying to improve himself. You know, he's always trying to better himself. And at some point, how much better can you get? So we went, you know, he's already pretty darn good. So we went, you know what might make me better if I owned a drone?
So I got to hand it to him. It did make him, it made him a little bit better that he owns the drone. I like him even more now. The drone's impeccable. And of course, the other cameras we use, we have a Sony, like an actual video camera that we use. I'm going to tell you whether you want to know or not about our tech. We got a Sony video camera we use, and then the rest of them are a motley assortment of GoPros. Now, I think the videos would look really good if we had like three or four matching GoPros. No, we don't. We have like one GoPro. That's a type of camera for those of you guys who don't know. We have like three or four different GoPros from three or four different generations of GoPros. We have like the GoPro 1, we've got a GoPro 4, and then we got a GoPro 7. I like the GoPros. They're all right. But the footage would look a little bit better if we had matching GoPros. One of these days, you know, I don't know. I'm boring you with technical details. I'm Jake Cowie from the Chardon Polka Band. Hope you've enjoyed the live stream tonight. Shared some music from the crew. Shared some personal stories. Shared how much I enjoy Mike Franklin and his drone, ladies and gentlemen. Is an invaluable member of the team because he plays the banjo and yodels, but the drone doesn't hurt either, ladies and gentlemen. Oh my goodness. Barbara Wild says, way to go, Mike and Mitch. She does not say, way to go, Bob Young, our drummer. That's okay. I don't say that either, you know. Oh my goodness. Of course, we got the dinosaur back there with the platform beer in his mouth. We got the deer over here. Let me flip cameras. You can see my deer's over there. And that's Chardon Polka Band World Headquarters in Burton, Ohio. It's August. It's mid-August. The date might be August 15th. That sounds about right to me. The date is August the 15th. So we're mid-August, and it's getting dark a little earlier. The summer is winding down, perhaps. Someone in the scroller asks, Jake, what were you supposed to cook tonight? Well, I was talking, Allison, why did you interrupt me? I was talking about summer winding down, and I had somewhere I was going, but I'm not going there anymore. What was I supposed to cook tonight? Well, I made us a big cookout lunch. We had grilled chicken, we had corn on the cob, and we had some oven roasted zucchini. So dinner was gonna be light. I was gonna do peanut butter and jelly, actually. That was my plan for dinner, but you know, it morphed into chicken Alfredo from the freezer. Friends and neighbors, that's all for the program tonight. I'd like to wrap it up with should I wrap it up with Goodnight Irene? I got some more footage of the band we'll play next week. We'll try and do another Zoom interview for you guys. So make sure you get us some questions and we'll answer them. We might not answer them well, but we will answer them. It's just a very different time we're living in. We're living on the time. We're living in the time. Make sure you be kind to your neighbors. Make sure you love your neighbors. Make sure you keep a polka in your heart all week long. It's like Christmas. You know, at Christmas, they all say, wouldn't it be nice if Christmas lasted all year long? Peace on earth all year long. Joy to the world all year long. And, you know, polka is like that. You know, don't just have your polka be 6:30 on Saturday evenings. Keep polka going all week. One way you can do that, tune into some other live streams, like our friend Valina and Dasis Lustig. They got a live stream probably starting right now, I think, or in another hour or so. Molly B and Ted do a live stream every Tuesday. That's phenomenal. You know, so keep those polkas in your hearts, in your stomachs, and in your brains. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Jake Cowie, and I've said that a lot tonight because I'm some days I'm not sure of it, but today I am. I'm Jake Cowie, and I'm going to close with Goodnight Irene. Cool. The Court of Ox is back to working order. Oh my goodness. There we go. The reverb button's going crazy on this thing. Last Saturday night,
I got married. Me and my wife settled down. Now me and my wife are parted, and I'll go to the other side of town. I ain't good night. I ain't good night. Good night, Irene. Good night, Irene. I'll see you in my dreams. Sometimes I live in the country, sometimes I live downtown, and sometimes I take a notion that'll jump into the river and drown. Irene, good night. What a sad song, right? Irene, good night. Good night, Irene. Good night, Irene. I'll see you in my dreams. Stop your rambling. Stop your gambling. Oh, stop staying out all night. Go home to your wives and your families and sit down by the fireside bright. Irene, good night. Irene, good night. Good night, Irene. Good night, Irene. I'll see you in my dreams. Irene, good night. Irene, good night. Good night, Irene. I'll see you in my dreams.
Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for listening. The whole Chardon Polka Band thanks you. I'm Jake, and hope you enjoyed the program.
Thanks for watching the Chardon Polka Band's Interweb Polka Extravaganza with Jake Cowie, Mike Franklin, Mitch Lawrence, and Bob Young. Join us again next time in the CPB World Headquarters in Burton, Ohio, for the country's greatest polka shenanigans.